Good afternoon, friends. I am Neeraj Bhadresa from Atmi Engineering College. Today we are discuss about some importance problem of the unit number 2 of GTU syllabus, that is function and limit. Up to now we have already discussed some importance problem of the function and limit also, and today we are discuss about one last problem, that is limit x tends to 1 x square plus 2x minus 1 divided by 2x plus 2. So we write down it. Limit x tends to 1 x square plus 2x minus 1 divided by 2x plus 2. So up to now we already discussed what is the procedure for solving the limit problem. That is, first of all check the denominator whether that is 0 or not. So if you check your denominator and put the limit, that is 1, replace with x, that is nothing but 2 into 1 and plus 2. So 2 into 1, that is 2, and plus 2 is equal to, so becomes 4, that does not is equal to 0. So we can directly replace limit with x, so we don't use your differentiation step, so that's why we replace x by 1. So our numerator becomes 1 square plus 2, replace x by 1, so 1 minus 1 divide by 2x, so that becomes 2 into 1 plus 2 plus 2 as it is. So we want to solve this problem. 1 square, that is 1, plus 2 into 1, that is 2, minus 1 divided by 2 into 1, that is again 2, plus 2. So this plus 1 and here minus 1, both are cancelled out. 2 divided by 2 plus 2, that is 4, and finally we got answer, that is 2 divided by 4, that is nothing but 1 divided by 2. So 1 divided by 2, that is our final answer. So our answer, that is 1 divided by 2. Now we move to our next question. Next question, that is based on limit using rationalization factor. So we require a rationalization to solve a limit problem. So first question, that is limit x tends to 0 under root of 1 minus x minus under root of 1 plus x divided by x. So we write down it. Limit x tends to 0 under root of 1 minus x minus under root of 1 plus x divided by x. So first of all we want to check our denominator whether it is 0 or not. So if we replace x by 0, our denominator becomes 0. So we use our differentiation step or rationalization step. Here we choose rationalization because this is nothing but under root type sum. So that's why rationalization of this sum, that is nothing but limit x tends to 0 as it is under root of 1 minus x minus under root of 1 plus x divided by x. Now take a rationalization of our numerator term, that is multiply with under root of 1 minus x. This negative sign becomes here positive sign, under root of 1 plus x. Now multiply and divide this term, both the side, so again denominator becomes same, 1 minus x plus under root of 1 plus x. Now we want to solve this problem. Now here we assume that this is nothing but take here x and assume here y, so nothing but under root of x minus under root y, and same way under root x plus under root y, so this is nothing but a square minus b square form. Because of a square minus b square, there is nothing but a plus b and a minus b. So we take, assume here a, that is 1 minus x, assume b is a under root 1 plus x. So our answer, that is a square minus b square. So this term square, and we require this term, second term square. So our answer, that is, first of all write limit, limit x tends to 0, a square, answer that is a square, so a, that is 1 minus x, so 1 minus x square minus b square, so our b value, that is 1 plus x, so that is 1 plus x square. So this is nothing but simplification of our numerator term. Now in denominator term, write down x into under root of 1 minus x plus under root of 1 plus x as it is, divided by x into under root of 1 minus x plus under root of 1 plus x. Now we know that under root square, so ultimately under root, that is, cancel out. So finally, if you want to simplify numerator term, then write down limit x tends to 0 as it is, this under root and this square, so both are cancel out, and remaining term, that is 1 minus x only, put minus sign as it is, under root here and square again cancel out, and remaining term, that is only 1 plus x, divide by x into under root of 1 minus x, put big bracket, so x, that is multiply with both the term, under root of 1 minus x plus under root of 1 plus x. Now we want to simplify our numerator, so our numerator simplification, that is nothing but limit x tends to 0, right, as it is, this 1 minus x, and here minus sign, so this minus multiply with 1 also, and this minus sign multiply with plus x also, so remaining term, that is 1 minus x as it is minus 1, minus sign multiply with 1, so that is minus 1, and this minus sign again multiply with x, so again minus x, divided by this term, put as it is, x under root of 1 minus x plus under root of 1 plus x. Now again we want to solve our numerator, this plus 1 and this minus 1 both are cancel out, and remaining term, that is minus x, and here minus x, that is nothing but minus 2x. So if we solve it, limit x tends to 0, this minus x and this minus x becomes minus 2x, divided by x multiply with under root of 1 minus x plus under root of 1 plus x. Now simplify again numerator denominator, this x and this x both are cancel out, and remaining term, that is minus 2 under root of 1 minus x plus under root of 1 plus x. Now again we want to check our denominator, that is 0 or not, so then and then we replace limit. So check the denominator, replace x by 0, so here 1 minus x becomes minus 0, plus here 1 and plus 1, so again we will solve, so here 1 under root of 1, and replace x by 0, so here 0, so under root of 1 plus under root of 1 is equal to 1 plus 1 is equal to 2, that does not is equal to 0, so finally we replace limit, that is nothing but replace x by 0. So finally we want to again solve this sum, so that is limit x tends to 0, here minus 2, replace with limit, that is under root of 1 minus x, that is becomes 1 minus 0, plus under root of 1 plus x, that becomes 1 plus 0. So this is nothing but solution of our sum. So again we want to simplify it, minus 2 divided by under root of 1 minus 0, that is 1, and again under root of 1 plus 0, that becomes only 1, and final answer, that is minus 2, 1 plus 2, that is 2, and this 2 and this 2 both are cancelled out, and final answer, that is minus 1. So our answer, that is minus 1, we write it. Now we move to our next question. Next question, that is limit x tends to a under root of x minus a, x minus under root a divided by x minus a. So first of all we write it, limit x tends to a under root of x minus under root of a divided by x minus a. So again our solution for this kind of sum, that is nothing but take a rationalization of numerator, because of numerator contain under root type term, so we require to cancel out this under root. So use a rationalization, that is nothing but multiply with under root x plus under root a, both the side, numerator as well as denominator. So again we simplify this kind of sum, that is rationalization. So here under root of x minus here under root of a divided by x minus a, multiply with this rationalization term, that is under root of x plus under root of a, and again under root of x plus under root of a. So if we multiply and divide, same term, numerator and denominator. Now again we want to simplify, this is nothing but x minus under root of x minus under root a, here under root x plus under root a, this is nothing but again we can say that a square minus b square type term, because of a square minus b square, that is a plus b and a minus b. So we assume at present here under root x, that is a, and under root a, that is b. So answer, that is a square minus b square. So our answer, that is here limit x tends to a square, that is nothing but x square at present, minus b square at present under root a square divided by this term x minus a, put as it is, and remaining term, that is under root x plus under root a. Now again we want to simplify our numerator, this under root and square, and again this under root and square, so finally both cancel out. So this under root and square cancel out, and remaining, that is limit x tends to a under root x square, that is x minus sign as it is, under root a square, that is only a, divided by here x minus a, here under root x plus under root a. Now again we want to simplify, this x minus a and this x minus a both are cancelled out, and check whether we should able to replace limit or not. Check the denominator whether that is 0 or not. Our denominator, that is not a 0, because this is here plus sign, and if you replace x by a, that is nothing but under root a. So finally we directly replace by our limit, that is nothing but numerator content, that is only 1, divided by this under root x becomes now a plus this under root a as it is. So final answer, under root a plus under root a, that is nothing but 1 upon 2 under root a. So 1 upon 2 under root a, that is our final answer. And we write here our answer, that is 1 upon 2 under root a. Now we move to our next question. Next question, that is limit x tends to 0 under root of 9 plus x minus 3 divided by x. So we write it first, limit x tends to 0 under root of 9 plus x minus 3 divided by x. So first of all, check, we can replace our limit or not. Here limit x tends to 0, here x, and denominator becomes 0. So we don't require denominator 0. So we have two type of formula at present. First one, that is differentiation. Second one, that is rationalization. Differentiation type formula already discussed. So today's section, that is only rationalization. And here under root, so we require to cancel out this under root and take a rationalization part. So numerator rationalization, that is nothing but under root of 9 plus x minus 3 divide by x, and take a rationalization of our numerator term, that is nothing but multiply with under root of 9 plus x, this minus sign replace here, plus, and multiply and divide this both the term to numerator and denominator. It is finally denominator side under root 9 plus x plus 3. So finally we have a sum, that is look like a square minus b square again. So a square minus b square, the solution, that is a minus b and a plus b. So at present a, that is nothing but under root 9 plus x, and b, that is nothing but at present 3.